Hello everyone, welcome to this new video. I will show you how to render an RDLC report in a WPF application. An RDLC report is an XML-based file that contains the report layout, parameters, and other report-related information.
The main difference between RDLC and RDL reports is that RDLC reports are designed to provide data from applications.
RDL reports, on the other hand, retrieve data by processing reports through a report viewer. You need to set three items to render an RDLC report in WPF Report Viewer. They are processing mode. This API specifies whether to process reports in the local or remote mode. Reports will be processed as RDL if the processing mode is set to remote, and RDLC if it is set to local. Report path. This API is used to set the path of the report that will be rendered in the WPF report viewer. Data sources. These are used to assign the required data to the report. Now, let's see how to create a WPF application. Open Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project. The Bold Reports WPF Report Viewer Control supports WPF App.NET Framework and WPF App.NET Core. For this demo, I select the WPF App.NET Framework from the listed template and click the Next button. I name my application WPF RDLC Report Viewer. Click the Create button, and a default WPF application is created.
Now, let me install the necessary NuGet packages.
In the Solution Explorer tab, right-click the project or solution
and choose Manage NuGet Packages. In the Browse tab, search for boldreports.wpf package
and install it. Boldreports.wpf
package contains WPF Report Viewer Control to preview and export reports.
Next, let me initialize the report viewer control. Open the main window.xaml file and declare the report viewer namespace into the page tag.
Then create the report viewer component inside the grid tag. Next, I create a folder named resources in the root folder of my application. This is where the RDLC reports are stored. For this video, I am going to add the product-list.rdlc file to the resources folder.
You will find the product-list.rdlc file link in this video's description. Next, I need to change some properties for the added report. I open the properties panel. Under the advanced section, I set the build action to content and copy to output property to copy if newer. Next, I create a class file named product-list.cs in the application root folder. In the product-list.cs, add the necessary using statements. I copy the code from the documentation and paste it inside the product-list class. Now, let me render the RDLC report in the WPF application. For that, I open the main window.xaml.cs file. Initialize the main window loaded method in the constructor and create a method in the main window class. In the created method, first I set processing mode to local. Then assign the report path to the report viewer.report path. I add the data value collection to the data source value. Here, name is case sensitive and should be the same as the data source name in the report definition. The value accepts ILIST, dataset, and data table inputs. Invoke the refresh report method to process and render the current report.
Next, I register the license token to remove the license validation message. In this demo, I am going to use the online license token. License tokens can be generated in the subscription section of the Bold Reports Accounts page. I open the app.xaml.cs file. First, I add the constructor for the app class and enter the code snippet to register the license token in the app constructor. I have provided the link to a video on registering a license using online license tokens and offline license keys in this video's description. I save the file. Everything is set to render the RDLC report from the WPF application. I build and run the application. See, the report is loaded. In this video, I showed you how to create a WPF application and declare the variables to bind the data source to render the report. I have provided the documentation link in the description below for the steps followed in this video. I have also provided a link to our article on enabling image rendering with the report viewer on Linux and other non-Windows platforms for your reference. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.